Okay, today we're going to talk about manifesting. Maybe in a little bit different way than you've heard about it before. I first read about manifesting, I don't know, 6, 7, 8 years ago, and I just thought I'd give it a try. And I thought, what will I manifest? And the idea came to me of a blue ball, a small blue ball. I saw the exact color, I saw the exact size, and I came up with the idea in so many words, but it just sort of appeared to me. It may have come, shall we say, from the subconscious. I thought, okay, I'll manifest a blue ball. And I saw the blue ball, and I even somehow suddenly knew where I was going to find it or where I wanted to find it. See, now I say these things that I did this and I did that and I did this, but it felt as though it came from the other side, that it was saying, blue ball, this size, this color, and here's where you're going to find it. I could say that my conscious mind thought of it. That's what I normally would say. But in retrospect, something else was sort of taking the reins. So I thought, here we go. And I was very excited. Oh boy, this will be fun. So I was excited to manifest just one blue ball. And I knew where I would find it. And when I would find it running down the street, Hobart Street, when I was going to run on my jog. So, just 2 days later, I'm running, I catch this color blue out of the corner of my eye, and there's this big blue ball. Here it is. This is the exact color that I envisioned, but it was way too big. And it was under, it was just like on someone's front lawn. I said, okay, well, you know, that's obviously not it, not it. So I went for the run for like an hour and a half. I came back. This ball was now under the back wheel of the mail truck. And the mail truck is about to run over it. So I thought, because initially I didn't want to steal some kid's blue ball. But this thing is about to get destroyed anyway. So, and somehow honoring the manifestation, I took it. I thought, well, you know, a win is a win. It's half a win. It's the color. It is the color. I saw it, but it was like, no, it's too big. But I thought, that's kind of cool. 2 days later, I'm running down the same road. Bingo. I find another blue ball. Pretty much exact same color as the first one, and pretty much the color and the size that I was trying to manifest. I thought, holy shit, that's pretty cool. What kind of ball was it? I don't know. Maybe a handball or something. Oh, wow! Wow! I did it! A couple days later, another blue ball. And this was really the color that I saw, but it was like a little, you know, I imagine something sort of harder. You know, but it was like, it's all the same color. I was doing it. And every time I found a blue ball, something in me just giggled, was so happy. It's like, I'm doing it, or something's doing it. And I felt this weird connection. I thought, this is so cool. Something that, it's working, it's reacting. It's something out there knows I'm trying to manifest blue balls. Then like a week later, this is the blue ball I envisioned. This is the color. This is the hardness. This is the exact size. This is the exact blue ball that I envisioned in my vision. What kind of, I don't know what kind of ball this is. It's like too, is it a handball? That's too hard for a handball, it's pretty hard. I don't know what it, but it's the blue ball. And I had never, ever seen any of these kinds of blue balls ever before. And I wasn't coming across yellow balls, purple balls, orange balls, green balls. I wasn't coming across any kind of balls, just these balls. Then, shortly after that, found another one. This used to be bluer than it is. It's kind of gotten sort of green over the ages. This happened some years ago. I found it, so I found another one. Altogether, I found 5 blue balls. Okay. The point of my story is, I just had fun with it. It's, if you're trying to manifest something, stop, rather than trying to manifest $1 million or a new car or whatever, do something fun. Do something so easy that you know you're going to manifest it. Later on, I manifested orange balls. I also manifested like those colored paper clips. Just stupid stuff, silly stuff. The stupid, silly stuff will give you such a great thrill, and it'll sort of get you, I don't know, what's the word? It will confirm that you know how to do it. And I've kept these balls for 7-8 years. They're extremely important to me. And anytime I think I can't manifest something, I just think, remember the blue balls. And doing stuff just for the hell of it. Don Juan told Carlos Castaneda the most important part of his teaching for Carlos was teaching Carlos how to do things just for the hell of it. A. B. Everything that Don Juan told Carlos was nothing more than learning how to replicate the energetic attributes of the energy body or of source energy. Are you saying the source energy just creates all that is just for the hell of it? Yes. Yes, I am. It does it just for the hell of it. And that's the only way it can create with such spontaneity and endless creativity, just for the joyous hell of it. Because it's fun. And that's what I did when I did the blue balls. It was just for fun. And I thought, and the thing is, when you think of what you're going to think of something that you think is so damn easy, it's going to happen. Because when you start finding these things, you're going to think, well, it wasn't that easy, and I'm doing it. Manifest whatever you want. Something simple that you really know you're probably going to find. It's really fun. I've not come across any kind of balls. Trust me. I notice. You know, I don't ever see any balls. So if you want to have fun with it, do it just for the hell of it. Manifest a pink hat or whatever. And where does this stuff come from? I don't.
What the hell?
My ear's doing something weird. I don't know. I don't worry about taking some kid's blue ball. That ball is meant for you. That, you know, pink hat is meant for you. And, you know, I mean, don't go around steal someone's pink hat when you're at the basketball game. But it'll just be sitting there waiting for you. And there you go. So manifest things, typically, when people talk about it, they get all serious and weird and new agey and annoying. Have fun with it. Do something really, manifest something really stupid. And it will give you this great feeling inside. Every time you find your stupid little yellow pen, you'll go, that's not just a yellow pen. That's the yellow pen that I wanted to manifest. And you find another yellow pen and another yellow pen and another yellow pen. So, I've been waiting like 7 years to do this video. Don't ask me why. What's this have to do with True Tester? You also want to play with True Tester. All the things that I've developed with True Tester, all the great discoveries I've made, books I've written, and the True Tester itself, I just did for fun. I'm just experimenting. People go, how do you do this? How do you do that? How do you do this? You know, no one ever told me any of this stuff. I just explored and had fun with it and had amazing results. When you are just having fun, you are a perfect replication of source energy, because all source energy is doing is having fun. That's what kids, little babies do. That's what puppies do. That's what dogs do. They have fun. They are pure energy, pure source energy. No expectations. And the other neat thing is, as the blue ball idea came to me, all of a sudden, I knew I was going to find it. I knew. And it's and this is like such an important point, and I don't know how to make it. Other than, well, first I'll say, you suddenly know, and then you anticipate finding it. A lot of people will say, you must anticipate, you must do it in order to make it happen. No. That comes second. That comes after you, something in you says, knows that you're going to find it. Then you anticipate it naturally. And I suppose your anticipation, you could say it has a cause and effect relationship with your anticipating, but I'm with your manifesting, but I don't think so. Because there really is no cause and effect. What happened was the other side sort of reached over and made the agreement inside me in so many words, and I knew I was going to find it. When you know you're going to find it, of course you're going to actually have anticipation. I would not say that the anticipation has an effect on your manifesting. Once again, I'm saying that comes second. What has an effect on your manifesting is this weird confirmation, this feeling within you that you know it's going to happen. I wish I could replicate that feeling with trying to manifest $1 million or whatever it might be. That's what you want, and that's why I say try something simple, because I theorize that at some point you might go, well, of course I'm going to find the the green rubber band. Of course, eventually I'm going to find one. Then something in you will say, oh yeah, you're definitely going to find it. It's like, really? It's like, oh yeah. And you're like, yeah, I am going to find it. Where is it? I just know. So it's the coolest damn feeling knowing that you're going to find your manifestation. And when you get it, you know what I know, is that the secondary anticipation really doesn't have that much to do with making your manifestation. Not in my opinion. It just comes naturally. Of course you're going to anticipate it. And I will say, as I was looking for the blue ball, I was like, I'm looking everywhere for the blue ball. There was great intensity. There was great focus, but it was very natural. I wasn't forcing myself to think about it. I naturally was like, so the key that to all this is that indescribable feeling of knowing it's going to happen.